In the meantime, I had progressed through school, and as we did not have much choice, we would always pursue a standard curriculum, and the subjects that we did was English, Afrikaans, which was the other language there, Latin, general science, history, and mathematics. And that was the standard education if you were going on to more important things. If you weren't going to go to university, then of course you did commercial arithmetic instead of Latin. That which sometimes was called, I think in my day, it was still called bookkeeping, but later they called it commercial arithmetic. It just sounded better. And I think that during my period in high school, I wasn't the sort of top of the class student. I was good. I always got into the first six, but people never pointed to me and said he's going to be the winner. And so I was quite this, and of course, when I passed my exams, I did get a first class, but I didn't get any distinctions, for example.
That's very surprising.
Yes, and all the people actually that were thought to be the real winners who got four distinctions in matric went on later to a life of total intellectual obscurity. And so I think that led me always to the conclusion that even if a student comes to me with a first-class degree, he has to prove to me he could have got a second-class degree if he tried. Because I think that kind of book learning and giving it back in examinations was not my forte. I think that. Because already I think I had started to ask questions beyond this, especially in science. I realized that what I was being taught in chemistry and physics and so on was just what was in the book and what you needed to do to pass in examinations,
Were
and
the
that
teachers any good?
the teachers were not very good. And of course, this is at a in a provincial place, in a provincial country, in a small school. But, one learned just the basic elementary parts of chemistry. Mathematics, did not take you as far as calculus, took you as far as a solution of quadratic equations.